Welcome back. The war drums are being beaten across the world. We're now seeing the president speaking in St. Petersburg, Russia, on this Friday as they begin to get to the bottom of whether there's going to be a House, whether there's going to be a congressional approval of the authorization for the use of military force in Syria. Everybody seems to be talking about it. James Shannon, by the way, with the Beaumont Business Journal, W.L. Pate, Beaumont City Councilman, Michael Troncalli with Orgain, Bell, and Tucker. Give me your views, Mr. Shannon. Should we be, is this a proper use of military might?
Well, a limited use, I guess. I'm reminded, my friend Michael Troncalli will back me up on this, there's a saying in the court system that hard cases make bad law. Syria is a hard case. The idea of what we're going to do, when we're going to do it, and how. I don't know. I feel some empathy for the president. He campaigned on the idea that you should consult Congress before you engage in
any
foreign misadventures.
Anybody think this is not a hard case? Anybody think this is an easy, as these things go, an easier call?
I think it is something that's not to be viewed in a political sense. It should be concerned, we should look at it from the standpoint of our long-term interest and the precedent that we set. I agree with James on that point. Is this a matter of our national security? Is this something that where we have a strategic interest, whether it's political
or
economic? I have serious concerns about going forward with this for a couple of reasons. For obviously, is it a matter of our national security, and is it something that is of vital interest to America? I question that. Now, I do believe that we have to be very careful. If we start a fight, we have to finish it. Mm-hmm. And just dropping bombs may create more problems for us down the road. And in fact, help folks we may not really want to help.
W.L. Pate, if we go in and do limited strikes for 2 days and we destroy some of the carriers of these weapons, you know, the delivery devices, if you will, and we maybe fire, you know, 20 missiles or our bombing or whatever the case may be, and 3 days later, Assad again uses chemical weapons. Where are we?
Well, when you look at this from the military standpoint, and I was fortunate enough to serve in the military,
yes,
and one of the things that I taught in Command General Staff College was the big picture, and that's what you've got to look at. What's the mission, and where are you going to go? What will you accomplish by doing this? And if there's not some end game, there's other than dropping a few bombs, blowing stuff up, what happens after that? You bring up an excellent point. And when you look at the fact that many of the same people who might say this is okay today, when Saddam Hussein was killing thousands of people, of the Kurds, with chemical weapons, they went, well, you know.
Was that generally the case?
Oh, sure. And let me tell you, there's a famous picture that's being circulated now that Rumsfeld's on his book tour of Rumsfeld with Saddam Hussein at the time they were gassing those people. And I suspect they were using American gas. But let me tell you something. The subtext to this whole discussion is the tissue of lies that was constructed to force the U.S. to go into war in Iraq. They floated the notion, never articulated quite to that extent, that Iraq was somehow behind 9/11.
You believe they were lies as opposed to bad intelligence?
They were lies. And Cheney, when the CIA didn't come up with enough incriminating evidence for Colin Powell's famous presentation of the UN, he made three trips out to the CIA to, as Tony Blair said, sex up the intelligence.
With all due respect to our good friend James, here are the facts. Find out. When you talk about terrorism, Saddam Hussein was paying $25,000 to the family of anybody that would go in and be a homicide bomber in Israel. Mm-hmm. Now, if that isn't terrorism, I don't know what is.
This is where I go back to our national security interest. With Saddam Hussein, there were serious questions and some evidence, whether Mr. Shannon wants to accept it or not, there was evidence that things were going on in that country that could harm America and America's security. We're not hearing that evidence here in the case of Syria. he's a bad guy. There are a lot of bad guys in this world. That doesn't mean that we just go around indiscriminately dropping bombs on people. And in fact, if we were to take Assad out, what is our alternative? We may end up with a force in Syria that becomes a real threat to the United States. And
you're missing the issue, fellas. It's not the narrow issue of whether or not he's a bad guy. It's did he use sarin gas on his own people? And we're looking at those 1,200 twitching corpses, not a blood drop on them. They were gassed. That's the issue. And this idea that Saddam Hussein was a bad guy, no. They were putting forth a theory. He had nuclear weapons. President Bush said, I don't want to wait for a mushroom cloud.
No, they said.
But just on Syria,
he had weapons of mass destruction. Uh-huh. He had weapons of mass destruction. Mm-hmm. And trust me, they don't all have to be nuclear. Ask yourself where Syria got all the chemical weapons.
The Soviet Union, but where was the WMD in Iraq?
Now is not the time to blame George Bush. And if we get into this, this will be now, Mike, Obama's
what
war.
I'm saying is that's the subtext behind which these assertions of misdeeds are being considered. Because, frankly, historians almost unanimously agree the Bush administration cooked up the cause for war against Iraq.
Actually changed the way the American people look at the war and whether the United States should be involved in a given conflict. That, when Southeast Texas Weekly continues.